Yes, guys, so I just got back from the cardio, as you saw in the first part of the video. I've just finished editing my YouTube thumbnail for this video, which will be going out very, very shortly. I have showered, I'm feeling a little bit better. The plan is for today, as you probably didn't see through that thumbnail, but it's going to be how I started the gym, how to start the gym more specifically, and kind of not make the common mistakes. And often you see many beginners make these mistakes, and it's only, you know, years even down the line that they start to get their training and everything on point. And what I want to do is I want to cut that short for you. And I want you, if you're starting the gym, to get a head start on me, or to get a head start on anyone else who didn't have this knowledge before they started. So without further ado, let me go and get some food and then we'll get on with the video. Secondly, I just wanted to mention this briefly because I haven't mentioned this yet, but we have just hit
200 subs.
It's not a massive milestone, let's be honest, but I'm grateful for all of you that watch my videos, all of you that have subscribed, because it means a lot. And this content season shit's gonna blow up, so all of you that watch it, I appreciate it. And it makes me feel good for all the time and stuff that I put into these videos, if you lot watch them in it. So yeah, cheers for that. 1,000, 10k, 100k on the way. Come on. Yeah, that's next. Anyway, let's get on with the video.
Right. Oh, here I am talking after having this meal. I've actually changed things up so much. Now, I'm obviously much deeper into the cut, just briefly talking about it. Got 80 grams of oats, like 1 tablespoon of cornflakes, apple, and 1 tablespoon of peanut butter as well. All mixed in here. So this is actually proper nice. Like, I'll be real, actually proper nice. You appreciate the nice food so much, you know. Do you know what the thing is? I'm saving so much money at the moment. Like, I'm not even putting money aside for a cheat day. So deep it like that. I actually can't have a cheat day. Well, I can, but like, I'm choosing not to have a cheat day. So this effectively is a cheat meal, even though it's not. Crazy sacrifices we've got to make. And let me watch this meal.
Visions on my path, I send it light and love. Frequency was low, I had to rise above. Searching deep inside, I think I found a plug. Take me as I am and for now who I was. Let's pick up ourselves and we put down the guns. Let's uplift our women, they the chosen ones. Hope I get my flowers for my day to come. This that type of truth to make your body numb. I don't know why. Why must we steal, must we hate, must we lie? People oppressed, they depressed out they mind. Dearly beloved, I was made for this. Yeah. I worked them nights just like a slave for this. Yeah. Giving all my love and all my pain for this. It ain't no game with this. I'm in my lane, I'm not entertained, cause I ain't saying shit. I'm in my bag and I'm gon' spaz in case you do forget. Yeah, he cool and they okay, but can't compare to this. I'm on my exodus, black is excellence. Speak my testament, check off my bucket list. Know what time it is, my whole body chill. My life super real, blessings too familiar. Switching my ways to better my days, I found me a queen, the one of my dreams. I'm living on high, out of the cage, out of the shell, into myself. Living the life, living in health, living in God, building the wealth. Niggas with pretty party on the boulevard and they will switch up on you any step. Niggas will take, they'll take it all till there's nothing left. I done seen homeboys with they straight face, pissed off cause it ain't them. Losing your focus, you hitting the rim. I'm in the studio, I'm in the gym. I got that F on the top of the brim.
Okay, so I've just got back from the gym, had a great session, leg session as always, and now into the main part of today's video, which is obviously how to start the gym if you're a beginner. Now, the way I'm going to go about this is I'm going to talk about it in three parts in order of importance. So that is consistency, nutrition, and training as a beginner. So let me start with training. Training as a beginner, you see, you usually see the same people doing the exact same things when they first enter the gym. And you've just got to remember that if you are someone who, you know, is experienced in the gym, to recognize kind of how naive people are, especially when starting the gym, it's really your responsibility to help them. You will see people do the same things. For example, coming in, bicep curls,
tricep extensions, you know, the odd shoulder exercise here and there, abs, these sort of things, and of course never train legs. And obviously, like, I can admit that I was a culprit of this as well. You know, I did all of these things. You know, I wanted to get big arms, and that's what obviously lots of people say, that like, oh, I just want to get big arms, when in reality your arms are relatively small muscles in comparison to the rest of the muscles in the body. So that's what you've got to realize when training. Here's what you should focus on if you're a beginner: compound movements with progressive overload. So compound movements essentially means a combination of muscle groups where they have to work together in an exercise. So examples of this are the common bench press, squat, deadlift, bent over row, shoulder press, you know, leg press, all these kind of exercises where multiple muscle groups need to get involved in order to perform the exercise, the maneuver. The mistake that people make is, by only training arms, for example, or biceps — a bicep is actually one of the smallest muscles in your body in comparison to the others, and most of the time, 2 to 3 exercises or sets max is enough for your biceps to be worked. So any more that you're doing is more or less just deteriorating your body by the second. First thing you should be focusing on is compound exercises. Progressive overload is more or less how it sounds. So over time, nothing too specific, keep these lifts, and over time, increase either the rep ranges or the weight. Not by very much, it doesn't need to be a lot, but you hear people like Greg Doucette say, you know, train harder than last time, which is, you know, it's true, because it's shown that your body, if you think about it, let's put it into basic science for a second, right? Your body doesn't want to change and get stronger, because that's not how it's naturally built. So in order for you to do that, you need to overload it with something that at the moment it struggles to handle, so that it adjusts and can adjust to lifting that weight in order to prepare your body for that thing. It's like with athletes, you know, when athletes train with their fitness, your body has to adjust to those circumstances to get better at it. So that's the other thing, progressive overload with your training. Moving on to nutrition. This is the second most important thing. And nutrition, honestly, when you're a beginner, you don't need to worry too much about it. I mean, I do say it's important, but as your beginner, you can have the worst diet in the world. You can train the most horrendously, you'd still make progress in the gym. It's guaranteed, pretty much. This is mostly because your body is instantly adjusting to training lifestyle. It's like when, after lockdown, for those of you who remember, when we go back to the gyms and we train legs, or we train all of our body muscle groups, and we're aching for days afterwards because we had that time off, that period of time off, not having to train them. So it's just your body adjusting again. So there's also this concept that you can also lose fat and build muscle at the same time if you're a beginner, especially, obviously, depending on your natural body type. But to keep it simple, for those of you who are beginners, if you are overweight and you're looking to lose weight, if you are underweight and you're looking to gain weight, you want to be putting yourself in caloric surpluses and caloric deficits. And I will say, I've said it on this channel before, but a caloric surplus is where you are eating more calories than essentially you're burning, and a deficit is when you're burning more calories than you're eating. But this is obviously relative, and it doesn't need to be a huge surplus or a huge deficit at all, just as long as you're training hard and having enough protein. Protein is the most important thing, I would say. So just make sure, if these are your goals, slight surplus or slight deficit, and lots of protein. Moving on to the third and most important, but unfortunately is the ultimate downfall to why so many people end up not doing so well, or they fall off, or they lose motivation, or they just can't stick with it, is the commitment element. Unfortunately, once you get past that phase of your body, you know, suddenly adjusting and making this rapid progress like this, it's gonna eventually flatten out and then almost dip a little bit. This is the most crucial phase, and this is where consistency is important. If you can just stick with what you're doing, make a routine, make a plan, guaranteed you will continue to see results. Because unfortunately, you progress at the start at a massive rate, and it can be quite demotivating to see that slow down and almost plateau. And if you do get to a point where you're plateauing,
this means, okay, maybe I need to change up. So as long as you're consistent and you're progressively overloading either weight or rep ranges, changing things up, then you're likely to be fine. And honestly speaking, you will continue to progress. In my opinion, it's just as simple as that. With me, I never did any of those things. I just went in there. I was naturally slim. I just went in there. I wanted to keep a six pack. I wanted to, you know, get massive arms. I mean, I still do want big arms because genetically, I don't think I have the best genetics for arms, but that's all I wanted to do. And I thought in my mind, I just needed to train them as much as possible. Then they'll grow. But obviously, that's not how it works. You are more likely to grow your arms with compound exercises where you're pushing your body to its limits in multiple muscle groups than you are in simple, basic isolation exercises like that. You want to stay away from the isolation exercises and you want to move towards the compound exercises. That's me. That's the end of today's video. I hope this has been helpful in some format. I did want to do more of a sit-down one because I do feel like I can get through to you better. If you have any questions, anything else you want to ask me, drop a comment or send me a DM. My Instagram will be somewhere on the screen now. And my other socials will be in the description below. As always, thank you for watching. If you did like the video, please like, comment and subscribe. And if you didn't, sorry, isn't it? But I'll try my best. You know what it is.
Hey, Nas, this mix sounds cool.
We got money to make. Yeah, we gon' do this today. I'm tryna whip in the riff. Mess up his leg, I fake it. Then I have time for no faking. Chasing the money, we racing. Loving the money, I'm missing. Deal with the bubble, we're facing. We got money to make. Yeah, we gon' do this today. I'm tryna whip in the riff. Mess up his leg, I fake it. Then I have time for no faking. Chasing the money, we racing. Loving the money, I'm missing. Deal with the bubble.